por mi madre que te voy a dar un par de corazones.
She's threatening to beat me.
She likes to embellish.
She just learned that word on TV.
Why are you being so impossible?
I'm a teen.
Hello, how's my daughter's only friend?
Mom.
I'm sorry, your child has no father, Mrs. Gutierrez.
Sorry, I finished the cereal and the milk.
Being a kid is stupid, and I'm moving on.
What happened to your teddies?
I decapitated them.
Grow up.
Hi.
Hi.
Would the ladies like a ride?
Yeah.
Yeah?
What are we doing tonight?
I should be out there getting a degree, not laying here with some married man.
Barely married.
Damn it!
Still here, Grace?
Okay, so what was it about the story that impacted you personally?
Well, you know, I was a rebellious girl myself. So I had, you know, a lot of conflicts with my mom when I was growing up. And now I have a very good, strong, close relationship with her. So I guess, you know, I understand the conflict that, you know, all teen girls go through with their moms. And I like the... you know, the fact that they, you know, solve it and get together again at the end.
How long did it take to shoot it?
The movie was shot in 22 days, which is a very tight schedule for a feature film. And we also had a minor, which is Sierra.
Yeah.
So I had 6-hour days with her. So that's half a day. So I practically shot it in 17 days. It was a massacre. Huge, hugely difficult.
Can you talk a little bit about the casting process? Was getting Ava Mendez and Patricia Arquette, was that a top priority when making this movie?
Yeah, I mean, when the movie got greenlit, that's because, you know, Ava decided to take on the role of Grace. I think she saw something that she hadn't seen done before. It's completely out of what people have seen, so I think that's exciting to watch. She played a very real, you know, working class girl, you know, with problems, immature, and at the same time very loving. So that's a cool thing.
How long did it take to cast the part of Ansiedad?
That, of course, was the hardest one because,
yeah,
you know, Ansiedad is the, you know, it goes through a whole range of characters within her character. You know, she starts as the naive, innocent girl and then goes to, you know, nerd, geek, bad girl, cruel, bully, and eventually just, you know, a really hurt girl. So that was a challenge, and we were very lucky to discover this girl. She's from Houston. She was born and raised in Texas, and I saw her audition in tape. You know, they sent it to me in YouTube, and she was awesome, and we were lucky to get her.
Would you say that was the most challenging obstacle in making the film?
I think movies that talk about, you know, the female experience, you know, with Latinas, they're challenging throughout because we work with very limited resources. So every day was a big challenge. For example, you know, the tight schedule, the fact that we shot in Vancouver and it rained every single day and it was cold. And, you know, Eva had to have her miniskirt and, you know, all the crew was in big winter gear and these poor two girls had, you know, little dresses. So that was challenging. I made the whole music in 1 week. You know, I did the whole, you know, Eva Mendez wardrobe in a day, you know. So every day was a challenge.
What would you say is your most favorite part of directing, like working with the crew to like visually convey the film or working with the actors to flesh out the characters?
What I love most is working with the actors. I mean, I like three things. I like to work with the writer to shape up the scenes, the characters, the storyline, and just really get the heart into the movie because that's something that I really like. The other thing I love is actors. I've worked, you know, with kids before. I made a movie called Under the Same Moon that had a boy protagonist. And, you know, I work with him very closely, and now it's Sierra. It's her first role in film, so she was terrified at the beginning, and she couldn't act. And so I worked with her very closely, and one day I just saw how it lit up inside of her, and she became the character. And she was just fantastic. And each one is very different. The guy that's playing Mission Impossible is a big comedy actor, a TV actor from Mexico. So he's a broad comedian. And with him, it's a completely different style to get him to that, you know, the subtlety of a character like Mission Impossible.
There's a scene in particular with Ansiedad where she ridicules her best friend. Is it difficult to shoot a scene like that with such emotional baggage?
It is very difficult because you're working with human beings. So even though it's a scene, you're making somebody insult somebody else in front of a big crowd of people. So that day, I Tavita, who is Rainy, she's a fantastic actress. She's so self-confident and beautiful inside and outside. And I was, her father was there. It was just a very, challenging moment. I kept the big, yelling and offense till the very last moment. And working with such professional actors like her just made it easy, but it's hard.
I really enjoyed the opening scene with the mother presentation. Mm-hmm. Do you feel like that scene kind of suggests the overall theme of the movie?
Mm. I think that every scene in the movie somehow is working towards, to create a single universe. So it's a coming-of-age movie in which every single character is going through a coming-of-age story, Tavita is having a big coming of age, the mom, Mission Impossible, who's also, doing the wrong thing for the right reason. So every one of the characters is contributing to the central theme.
That's true, yeah. Had you always wanted to be a filmmaker?
Yes, I grew up in a city where there was no film school, and so I wanted to study film. I did communication sciences because there was one class that was film on my fourth year. So I waited for 4 years. And then I became a journalist, but I interviewed film people because I wanted to be in film. So in a way, I was always trying to, head into that. I never knew I was a director. I didn't know what I was. I knew I had to be in film. And then I became a producer, and eventually I quit my job and I went back to school. To discover who the hell I was, and I directed for the first time, and that's when I knew that I had to direct, and that's my calling. That it's the only thing I want to do, and the thing I do best.
Is there certain directors that you draw upon?
I love watching movies. I'm not a director that has like an influence, like I like this director, so I watch his films 25 times and then I sort of emulate them. No, but I do love films, and when I watch a good film, it teaches me so much. It's so inspiring to watch good movies. Unfortunately, ever since I became a director, I have so little time to watch movies. It gets harder and harder because I just, wish I had more time to watch a movie every day.
Yeah, because you co-wrote this, your upcoming picture, Elsa and Fred.
Mm-hmm.
What can you tell us about that?
It's actually a remake of an Argentinian movie. So I just finished the script. I adapted it to the U.S. And, we're looking for 75-year-old couple, actors, couple of actors. So I'm looking at Michael Caine, Jane Fonda, or Shirley MacLaine.
I heard about that one, yeah.
And so it's a romantic comedy in the senior years, which I think it's another underserved audience,
What would you say is like your dream project, like a certain book that you've read and that you said that I want to make that film? Or a certain movie that you want to remake?
Mm-hmm. I like to work with I guess the underdog. Like, I like to give voice to people that don't really have it. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I'm attracted to that kind of material. I'm also a big fan of romantic, big romances on screen, and we don't see those that much. And so at some point I want to do a big heartbreaking romance. It's going to break my heart, but I'm going to do it.
Is there any actor, actress that you would just love to work with in the future?
I like all actors. You know, I work with new actors all the time, with kids, with old people, I like to. And then every now and then, you know, with good seasoned actors like Matthew Modine, you know, he's such a good actor. He plays Dr. Hartford in Girl in Progress. Just throw me anything, you know. My challenge is to make it all work and to get, you know, help them get a great performance. I guess when I work with really great actors, they sort of do it themselves, but you still need to shape it. So, you know, the bigger, the more intimidating, but I'll take on the challenge.
What are you expecting audiences to take away from this film?
First and foremost, I want them to have fun and to be entertained, because I think, you know, we go to see movies because we just want to have a great time. But I think for me, it's really important that to make movies that also leave something in you. You know, you walk out of the theater most of the times and you don't even remember what you saw. Like, you're entertained and that's it. But I think Girl in Progress stays with you. And I've been noticing the reactions from people is that it elicits communication and conversation between moms and daughters. Like, moms want their daughters to see it, and daughters go and talk to their moms for the first time. So I'm excited that the movie is opening on Mother's Day weekend. I think it's a really good date for a movie about women, made by women. So I'm hoping that they come out all and see it. I think it's a good Mother's Day gift.
A coming-of-age story is the story of a young person's interchange from child to adult.
Don't wait up!
And are those as separate as we've been led to believe?
My mother never finished high school. She was 17 when I ruined the party. She keeps saying she's gonna go to night school, but she never will.
Your daughter's tuition is showing unpaid. Your last two checks gave us some trouble.
Oh, God, I need 6 more jobs.
I cannot afford to pay the bills.
Clean slate, just you and me, just the two of us.
Just the two of us?
Why aren't you ever here?
Your daughter, she's trying to grow up. I think she believes experiencing certain things will speed that process along.
She's trying to leave home, like you left home.
How dare you judge me? I was a little kid. My mother was never there for me.
Constantly changing throughout our lives? And isn't that a good thing after all?
Did you win that?
In chess.
How nerdy!